Welcome to my tutorial about these beautiful flowers. They've got 3 layers of petals, 5 petals, 5 petals, and at the back 5 petals. I'm using hook number 5 and simple baby yarn. I will start with making slip knot. And the chain of 5. Then I tighten together. Chain 1 and 10 single crochet in the middle of my loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I will make a slip knot. Then we will start our first row of petals. Chain 1 and 3 double crochets. Chain 1, going to the next single crochets, making slip knot, chain 1 and working in the next single crochet, making 3 double crochets, 1, 2, chain 1 into the next single crochet, chain 1 and making 3 double crochet in the next single crochet, chain 1 in the next single crochet. Making, we can make slip knot or we can make a single crochet here. It really doesn't matter. Chain 1 and 3 double crochet in the next single crochet. Chain 1, single crochet, chain 1 and 3 double crochet. 1, 2, and 3. Then single crochet or slip stitch. I will make slip stitch here. Now we are going to make second row of our petals. So I'm making chain of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And connect it to the slip stitch between the first and second petals at the back loop of the slip stitch. Make another slip stitch, chain 4 into the slip stitch between the petals, back loop. Chain 4 into the slip stitch between petals, slip stitch, chain 4 into the slip stitch between petals, back loop, chain 4, into the first slip stitch. Try to get into the back loop, but if it doesn't go into back loop, do it in a both loops. Voila. So these petals will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 double crochets. So it will be chain 1, 7 double crochet, chain 1, and connect it with slip stitch or single crochet again. So I'm making chain 1 and 7 double crochet into this chain. Chain 1 and making a slip stitch, again chain 1, 7 double crochet into the next chain space, chain 1 and going into slip stitch, chain 1 and 7 double crochet in 1 into the single crochet. Six and 7, chain 1 and slip stitch or single crochet. At this stage, this flower could be finished if you want. or we can make another row. This row I made from the middle of the petals. I think it looks nicer. So instead of going from the this joint to this joint, it will go from the middle to middle. So first I need to take my slip, my stitch to the middle of the petal. I will make chain 2 and make a slip stitch into one of those double crochets. Could be in the middle, but I wouldn't count in this thick part, and making a slip stitch. So now I will start working chain of 4 and make a slip stitch into the next petal, somewhere there. Chain 4. Slip stitch at the back of double crochet, chain 4, and slip stitch into the next petal. Chain 4. Slip stitch into the next petal. Chain 4. And slip stitch into my last petal. Chain 1. And making double crochets. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Chain 1. And slip stitch into the slip stitch. Let's make again chain 1, we are making into this chain space what we've created, making 9 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Chain 1 and slip stitch . If you struggle like me to make a slip stitch here, do a single crochet right at the end of this petal. Chain 1, another 9 double crochets. And single chain one and single crochet. I will make a couple more. Chain one, 9 double crochet, single crochet, chain one, my last petal, one, two, three, six, nine. Chain one and single crochet. I will secure it like this. Chain one and job has done. Let's take this and over this side, and we can secure it somewhere here in the middle of the petal. I like to leave this edge in case you want to attach it to your garment or somewhere. This is what we made. If you like my video, please subscribe, hit the bell.